My name is Dr. Jimmy Lamo. I'm a rice breeder working with the National Agricultural Research Organization based at Namlonge in Uganda. We have been partners in conducting a project which is called SARD-SC, where rice was being promoted along the value chain. In Uganda, this project, which came from 2012 to 2016, found us with a range of technologies, which the project helped in upscaling. And the first are the rice varieties. We had upland rice varieties, which were higher yielding than the previous one and better adapted to different locations, and some of them semi-aromatic. These are the Arica rice varieties and the Namche rice varieties. So when the project started, this variety was released in 2013. Then in 2014, the first ever release of irrigated rice happened in the country, and the demand was growing. So we took up training seed growers as one of the segments very important in the value chain. We trained seed growers in the hubs, which were already being developed under the project. The one hub is the Doho hub. The second one is Olweny hub. In Doho hub, they took off very fast because infrastructures needed for irrigation were already in place, and they were able to multiply seed adequate for the farm. Olweny strategically had an opportunity and a challenge. It had a delay to start because the irrigation infrastructure was just being developed. But when it was developed, the farmers who were trained produced quality seed of both upland and irrigated rice. Now the demand of seed surpassed the level at which it was being produced, partly because commercial farmers came in play. A number of commercial farmers having around 10,000 acres came to our seed growers who had very clean seed. Now this also coincided with the time when seed companies were not producing adequate seed, partly because it's an inbred and not very attractive. They imagined it may not be very much on demand for many seasons. So this became a niche for our newly trained farmers. All the seed that they produced in the first season, 20 tons, were purchased by just one investor. Then in the subsequent seasons, more seed were procured. And in total, certified seed of around 85 tons were procured during this whole project period. Now, in order to make the seed production more efficient, with the same project, we brought in labor-saving technologies, which bring in clean seed production, timely weed management, better field management, and also input. Now, this came hand in hand with the agronomy task force, which was continuously testing the best packages with the farmers in each of the locations. We therefore feel the SARD-SC was timely and a great success. First, because we had new technologies that needed to be upscaled. Second, the demand was high and growing. Where we are is even more interesting, because Uganda currently has a high number of refugees, and they are fed using rice. So those who go into rice production is a niche where they benefit from. A second aspect is that these very refugees are now being empowered to be rice farmers so that they're self-sufficient in rice. That again needs seed. We therefore see the next phase making us reorganize, be able to produce adequate seed for the farmers who are small scale in capacity, then also the medium scale farmers who are coming, and then the refugee population. Current information indicates that there is the second highest number of refugees in the world are now in Uganda. We therefore think if the trained seed growers are empowered, probably with a revolving fan, better storage facility, they can supply adequate quality seed for the country and for the growing demand in the neighboring countries. Thank you.